Good crowd on hand, as you expect, between these two in-state rivals. Several players on the USI roster from Central Indiana, so a good chance for friends and family to make a little less of a drive to come watch them play. Quick set and bombs away for, again, one of the returnees for IUPUI. That is Morgan Ostrowski, the sophomore from Garrett, the former Railroader, the unique nickname of the Garrett High School teams up in Northeast Indiana. Morgan came in with 57 kills on the season. An immediate service ace by IUPUI, and that's one of the veterans. That is Brooke Phillips. She is a senior from Franklin Community High School. Began her volleyball career at Lipscomb down in Nashville. New director of athletics, Luke Basso. He of the red shoes watching from the baseline. Off the block and steered wide. First point of the match to go to the Screaming Eagles of Southern Indiana. So USI to serve. And for USI, this is their final non-conference match. As that's in for a kill for USI. We're tied at 2 points apiece. USI will open up league play with a match against Eastern Illinois. That comes up in 5 days. That's next Monday. Short set, big swing. Was there a touch there? Yes. Point goes to USI, so three consecutive points go to the Screaming Eagles. Last year, USI's lone victory came against their fellow OVC debutante in Lindenwood. And that's an ace off the tape for USI. Make it four consecutive points for the visitors. Set across, big swing, and a kill. That is Maya Long, freshman from Erlanger, Kentucky. That is Northern Kentucky, the Cincinnati suburbs. Let's take a look. Pass sent her way by Grace Parika. And I'm not surprised that Grace was simply handed the ball and said, you are running this offense as a freshman. Part of the Parika family volleyball dynasty from Providence High School in Southern Indiana. On the set, the tip. That's, nope. Thought that was a dig for a moment, but the assistant there in the corner said nope, contact was made on the floor, so point goes to USI. Libero rotates out, and Kira Moore for Southern Indiana. I mentioned Grace Parika, there's Grace. Her mom, her head coach at Providence, and some great things with the Union Volleyball Club in the Kentuckiana area. Set across, block is there waiting. Jaguars try to peel it off the net, and they can, but then is trying to tip that one and misses it wide. And the Eagles now bump their lead to three. And for IUPUI, they have one more non-conference match. Looks like the Jaguars are going to challenge. So obviously we have replay availabilities in our broadcast tonight. So the ask for the review, I think, is again is on net contact against Southern Indiana. Great that we have the net cam, the GoPro, to see if there was net contact. And it's the best angle you're going to have, obviously, but tough to tell if there was contact made. Again, if it would be the outside hitter on the block, and the arms come down, is that enough to definitively say, yep, there was contact there? That's simply the natural follow-through of the ball. Net contact is deemed to have happened, then it's a point IUPUI, and it's a one-point USI lead. If not, the Screaming Eagles lead will stay at three. Andrew Kroger briefly talking with his team. USI content to wait this one out. We'll officially hear from our R2 on the ruling. And the challenge does not work for IUPUI. So the point remains with the Screaming Eagles. So 6-3 for the visitors. Parika sends it across. Block is there waiting. Double block for Southern Indiana. It was led by Bianca Anderson. Anderson third on the team in kills. With 55 coming into the match. She is a sophomore from the Chicagoland area. Off the slide, Ostrowski. Not sure if that was a block or simply an error on the swing. And not exactly a dynamic start for IUPUI. After taking the first couple of points, Southern Indiana has now won 8 of the last 9. And Jags will play at Indiana State on Friday. It's Ashley Pritchard's squad. Great recovery by USI. Jaguars read that one well. Point goes to IUPUI. And Ostrowski back to serve. Quick substitution for the Screaming Eagles before Ostrowski serves. Now we have a challenge from Southern Indiana. So both teams taking a look at replays early in the match. And Coach Kroger getting a full explanation as to what the call is going to be here. And we will learn exactly how the challenge will work in terms of angles we can see. We've got 4 cameras we can potentially take a look at. I think the question is, was that ball actually wide? And obviously, we are looking through. That is the team manager for USI that we're trying to see between clipboard and haircut. Was that ball wide or not? And obviously, there is a line judge just off camera to the right that in theory would have the best look. Ball's right in front of the R2, who is looking at the challenge as we speak. Let's see Coach O'Coin. Became the 13th head coach in USI volleyball history heading into this year. And already he has done great things, and the point will simply stay with IUPUI. To Ostrowski back to serve again. She has played in every set but one so far this year. She has started all 10 matches for the Jaguars this season. Jags will open up league play with Cleveland State next Tuesday. We'll have that one for you. John Herrick will have the call on ESPN+. Harris just tries to steer that one down the line. Double block waiting, though, for IUPUI to send that one towards the floor. Emily Allen, one of the 2 seniors on this IUPUI roster from Burlington, Wisconsin. She was flanked by Harris to her left. And that draws the applause of Luke Basso behind the play. So back-to-back points for the Jaguars. Good read by Harris. Right idea by the center for USI on the one touch. Just put a little too far behind her teammate. It was Lauren O'Neill that couldn't find her teammate that time. You see Ostrowski, she was an outstanding basketball player her days at Garrett as well. Set across to Harris, big swing, but that went off the antenna. That's the reason why the line judge again raises his flag immediately. Now So the point goes to USI. So an error on the swing. Was there a touch there? Yep. Mile-long try out of the way, but couldn't dodge that one. So the ace to USI. Long serve, and that time, no one to get in the way for IUPUI. Parika will drop back to serve for the Jaguars. The Parika name may not be common in most parts of the world. It is here in the Indianapolis area, even though Grace grew up 2 hours south of Indianapolis as Harris swings and misses. The Parika family name is very common in terms of football in the Indianapolis area. USI to serve. Good job to kind of swing around that pass that time and read the block as well. That was not the chance for the fastball. Kate White with the lefty swing. Freshman from Coleraine High School, north side of Cincinnati. And now Harris will drop back to serve. That's an ace. Goes right down the back of Leah Anderson, who had hoped the ball would kind of float long. It did not. Second ace for IUPUI. Free ball here for the Jaguars. Parika, short ball, and libero couldn't do anything with it. Jaguars back with another point. So the Jaguars have stemmed the tide. That one will float long, and such is life with a young team. You'll get momentum on your side and get away with the service error. Jaguars, in fact, have had 121 of those coming in. Nearly double the amount that of aces they have had. And USI themselves, again, maybe a little more experience as a team, but so many of these players new to Division I, gives it right back. So the teams exchange service miscues. And Addie Evans back to serve. Addie has played in about two-thirds of the set so far this year. Set across, USI the dig. Going over on two, Jaguars have it covered. Another free ball for IUPUI. Bigger swing and not the result. IUPUI had hoped for a touch, it was not there. Point to USI. Soboralski now will head back to serve, but as we mentioned, she is one of the many players playing today that I guarantee you have friends and family in attendance. She's from the southeast side of Indy, Franklin Central High School. Bit of a campfire that time by USI. They do keep it in play. Block is there, and point is there as well for IUPUI. Phillips will return to serve. Good work by Ostrowski there on the block. And again, another giveaway. Well, it's one thing to be aggressive on serve. You don't want to make the serves too easy to return, but Jaguars are giving away a fair amount of points on service errors. They're averaging just under 4%. That'll come back to haunt you. The block there waiting by Southern Indiana. Give that one to Paris Downing. She, too, local product. She played at Avon High School. That'll lead us to our media timeout here in set number one. So we're back inside the IUPUI gymnasium. Jeffrey O'Coin and the new head coach of the USI program. And the two teams in a charitable mood in terms of service giveaways so far in this one. So Long now back to serve. Off the block. Jaguars able to track it down, and this one steers wide. Point to IUPUI. So back-to-back markers for IUPUI, and they're back within one. Long this season, a team-high 99 kills coming into the match. But another service error for IUPUI. Libero rotates out for USI. That's Moore. A little deeper bench for this IUPUI, or for this USI team, I should say. Parika, short set, big swing. And that one takes a walk on the tape. Jaguars never touched it. See four fingers in the air. One too many touches for the Screaming Eagles. That one took a walk. If that thing had turned the other direction, that would have been awfully difficult to deal with for IUPUI. You get the home court net, but you've heard this before. Another giveaway of serve by IUPUI. It's Abby Bednar now to serve. One of the seniors on the Screaming Eagle roster. Block is there. USI couldn't chicken wing that to keep it in play. Give the kill to the Jaguars. That's eight for IUPUI. And there's also been just a few too many errors for the Jaguars so far. Hitting numbers aren't great for either side. Jaguars at triple zeros right now. USI hitting 063. And no touch there. Nope, there is a touch there. My apologies. Point goes to IUPUI. So Parika back to serve. And it looks like USI will use a challenge. Or is it a timeout? And there will be a challenge involved here. So I didn't think there was a touch either. At least at first, but saw the flag go up. This will give you a pretty definitive view. And obviously what you are looking for is a change in trajectory, a change in the spin of the ball. That's about as close as of a look as we can give you. And usually you would say that is also a sound call. It's an auditory react, which obviously on the challenge we're not going to be able to provide you in terms of the replay. As it stands now, all level at 17 points apiece. And again, because there wasn't a definitive look, Jaguars will maintain the point. And they are back on level footing for the first time in some time. Parika already 265 assists on the season. Block there waiting, but IUPUI. It's one of a little sticky one that time. Couldn't get off the hands. Give White the kill. Now IUPUI seesaws back in front. Tough ball by Parika for an ace. Jaguars played the first three matches of the season in Peoria, Illinois. Winning 2 of 3. Short set, big swing, and kill by USI. Winners Jaguars went 2-1 their first two weekends of the season. They struggled last week. The home of the Coyotes. University of South Dakota off the slide. USI has that covered. Blocked there, but steered wide. We're back level at 19 points apiece. Parika did what you could with it. Block is there, but couldn't pick it out of their hands from Leah Anderson. Anderson, a senior from Bloomington, Illinois. And USI seesaws back in front. Anderson second on the team in kills coming into tonight's match. Short ball block waiting. Good lefty swing. Good angled swing that time by Kate White. We're tied at 20 apiece. White and Harris, each with three kills, lead IUPUI. White, the best hitting numbers so far for the Jaguars at 333. Great dig for the Screaming Eagles. Free ball here, and the scramble by IUPUI. Ball still in play. Set across for Anderson. Parika the recovery. Going over on two, and well done. Sometimes setters can kind of fall in love with that play. That was not the case that time for USI. Soborowski read that one well. Great diving effort along the back row. Through the block. The hammer. Dropped that time by Downing. Downing has played in every set this season so far for USI. One of four players with 50 or more kills on the season. And the Jaguars take a timeout. So USI 3 points away from the finish line in set number one. This reminder that Horizon League and our members live and play in the largest and most vibrant cities in the country, allowing our student athletes exposure to unique experiences only available in major cities. To learn more about all our major cities, visit horizonleague.com/brandrecharge. Of course, from here in Indianapolis, that includes places like Lucas Oil Stadium, the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, and for selected student athletes of men's and women's basketball, it'll be the all-new Pacers Pavilion. Downtown next to Gainbridge Fieldhouse. It's media days for men's and women's basketball take place a week from today at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum, once again home of the Horizon League men's and women's semifinals, where you get to early March. So Kira Moore awaits. Moore, a local product for USI, as into Evansville. Played at Castle High School. Parika the set. Big swing, big result. So Long with the kill. Her second of the night. Good elevation for the freshman from Northern Kentucky. Anderson blocked there, but wide. Another good-looking swing from the lefty. Well, Kate White's been the most effective hitter for IUPUI so far in this opening set. The Jaguars' hitting numbers now up to 125. White's numbers at 375. Phillips to serve. Crucial point here, won by USI, and they'll have themselves a pair of set points. Good job in finding that seam that time by Bednar. And the tape kind to the Screaming Eagles. And Ostrowski's ball is long, just steered it long, and USI claims set number one, 25-22. It was a decisive run, 8 out of 9 points. Is there going to be a challenge there by IUPUI? Coach Kroger talking to our R2 about, I'm not sure if it's a rotation issue or what the story may be.
Set number one to USI.
So there will be a challenge before the set is officially concluded. So business not necessarily done just yet. It's the third one of these we have had so far in this opening set. See Coach Kroger joined by Becca Strange and Simone Abbott. And they're asked if there was net contact there made by USI. I don't think so. I don't think there's any doubt about the ball being long. You had a good view of it. So did the line judge. Is there contact here on the follow through from any of the players in the block attempt? Going frame by frame as best we can for you on that, but I'm not sure that IUPUI will get the result they're looking for here in trying to keep this first set alive. So let's see the call. Point goes to USI, and set number one goes the Screaming Eagles as well. So the first set belongs to the visitors, 25-22. And as these two teams race for a fifth victory in non-conference play, teams' chains ends will step aside. Set number two comes your way next from downtown Indianapolis. So USI, we'll see IUPUI serve first here in set number two. And for the Jaguars, we'll see Brianna Brown enter the lineup here in set number two. Again, she's one of the returning veterans on this IUPUI squad. And USI took 8 of 9 points in a stretch in the opening set to take an 8-3 lead, and you wouldn't say cruised, but had the better of it from that point. Big swing in the middle, big block waiting in Ostrowski. So Phillips again will serve. Two players trying to take up the same space. It ends up working just fine for IUPUI. Nearly a miscommunication, but perhaps that threw off the defense of Southern Indiana as well. So first 2 points belong to IUPUI. Wicked knuckling serve by the lefty in Phillips. blocked there, but steered wide, and it's first set, first 20 long to IUPUI. Now in set number two, first 3 points belong to IUPUI. End of the tape. And service error is a problem in the opening set for the Jaguars. Had four of them. USI donated some back as well. They had three. Like that. Happened often in the opening set. Brandon Brown will rotate back out as Ava Harris returns. Short ball, Ostrowski. Good job by the libero to dig that one out, but bad pass, double contact. First time we've seen that call tonight. Sydney Beach, Katie McCaffrey, observing all the action from the IUPUI bench. Largest lead of the night so far for IUPUI. Quick set, big swing. Good job to react by Downing. The scramble by the Jaguars. And just not able to control it. Off the dig was Addie Evans. Evans, one of three juniors on this IUPUI roster. Ostrowski did the best she could with that. And Parika says, all right, I'll go over on my own. And wide. Good eyes by IUPUI. Libero rotates out as Emily Allen will come back in. Libero rotates back in for USI as Moore return. Point to Southern Indiana. Giving Anderson the credit for the kill that time. Not much the Jaguars could do there. Good job. Good read that time by Harris. Harris with the block there to said, all right, we're just going to tip this one through and up and over. Another giveaway on the serve by IUPUI. I think that's six for the night. Both teams doubling up their ace total with their error total, unfortunately, so far in this match. Almost an ace there. Good effort by the Jaguars to keep it going. And how about that, pulling a point from that predicament? That was a millimeter away from being an ace. Instead, it's a point to IUPUI. So Jags doubling up USI early in set number two. Parika the dig. Right idea, just too much on it. There goes the right read. Entire defense had rotated forward for IUPUI. And a timeout going to be taken by Southern Indiana. So IUPUI trying to level this match and off to a good start in set number two. They lead it 9-4. Back in a moment on ESPN Plus. So back to action here in downtown Indy. Jaguars served 9-4. USI took set one, 25-22 block is there, and it ricochets off of Anderson. Point to IUPUI. Too much on that one. Again, the right read by IUPUI. So the attacking error against USI. And that one sails long. Jaguars give it right back. It's an IUPUI team that had six non-conference wins a season ago. They can still get to that number this year. Take on Ashley Pritchard's team at Indiana State coming up on Friday. Off the block and down, point to IUPUI. Of course, Ashley, the former head coach at Marion, led them to an NAIA national championship before making the jump to Terre Haute. So here's Evans. Block is there, and in the court of play. Timing of that pass was just a little off. Left hitter, not much choice but hitting into that block. USI just a little out of sorts here in set number two. ...50-50 ball, and Jaguars win it. But, as has been kind of the MO for IUPUI tonight, they have been handing out some free points on the service errors. So Soborowski to serve. And bad pass by IUPUI. Back-to-back easy points for the visitors. But still a seven-point cushion with which to work for IUPUI. Ostrowski, and had to swing around that one. Block is there, but wide. So make it three in a row now for USI. Good reset by the Jaguars. And that's double contact or lift, excuse me, going to be called against USI. Phillips will rotate back into serve. Phillips has been kind of a one rotation player tonight for the Jaguars. She got him off to a good serving start here in this second set. But couldn't earn the point this time for IUPUI. So the Eagles have found their footing. A little bit more here in set number two, but again, still have a six-point hill to climb. Dive here by Parika that goes off the rafters, hence the quick adjustment. Set across. Net contact. There have been a couple of asks for that, but never actually made. Bednar got into the net that time. Point goes to IUPUI. And no argument from USI. Tough serve. Short ball, big swing, and a touch there by Anderson. I think she'd like to have that one back if possible, but I'm talking about a split-second reaction. You've got less than that to guess. Is that ball in or out? So the Jaguars, the benefactor. And off the block and down. Jaguars hitting a crisp 471 in this second set. Well, USI right now in negative territory at 087. And that one misses wide. So literally, USI with 10 points in this second set. Five have been handed to them on service miscues by IUPUI. Here's Audrey Crowder. She too from Avon on the west side of town. Point for IUPUI. Jaguars now 6 points in the finish line here in the second set. Another one handed away by IUPUI. Bednar to serve. Barica's short ball. Anderson off the block and down. Bednar enjoying her fourth year of playing at USI. Off the slide. Block there and steered wide. USI is kind of unable to get that momentum back on their side. Parika to serve. Big swing, block there. Parika retrieves it. 50-50 ball, and was there a touch there? If there's a touch there, the points to IUPUI, and that's the case. That's what Andrew Kroger was asking about. So there was a touch there, right? And he was correct in his assessment of the situation. What a reaction on that second touch by USI. And then the errant swing by Kate White. And such a young IUPUI team. So many of the names that we call. Playing in their first season at the collegiate level. Free ball here that IUPUI didn't take advantage of. Yeah, that was a mistake. Jaguars had an easy ball that they could have handled and just didn't do it. So Abby Weber. Weber A. Jr. again, another local product, Hamilton Southeastern. Off the slide, Allen blocked there waiting. See if Coach Kroger wants to put a stop to this here with a timeout. Eagles back within six. Well, that'll be a momentum killer right there. USI has not been doing that as frequently as their competition tonight, but Jaguars will take the free point when given to them. Short ball. Parika sets across, and point goes to IUPUI. Jaguars 2 points away from leveling this match at a set apiece. Going over on two, Jaguars have it covered. Off the block and down. Give that to Anderson. Anderson with four kills. It is Leah Anderson's five that paces the way so far for the Screaming Eagles. Big swing, big result. And it is a fistful of set points for IUPUI.
Set point to IUPUI with Evans to serve.
In fact, they have seven of them. They could hate of them. They'll need at least more than one. That's Downing. Who wins that one for USI? Her third of the night. So Moralski, not a serve. Block there, waiting. Ostrowski ends it for IUPUI. So, Screaming Eagles take set number one, 25-22. IUPUI responds, never trails in set number two. They claim that one 25-17. We are at least going four tonight inside of the IUPUI gymnasium.
USI to serve set number three with Carly Storowski.
So Parika, Ostrowski, Brown amongst those on the floor to start the third set for IUPUI. Block is there. That one, was there a touch there? Yes.
Point to USI.
So USI with the point. There have been some net contact there too, looks like. Either way, first point belongs to the Eagles. Ostrowski, good job to kind of rotate around that pass. Refers the fact that she was a high school basketball player at Garrett. Her team got to the semi-state her senior year. Happened to run into the eventual state champions in South Bend, Washington, unfortunately, in the northern half of 3A. Another service error by IUPUI. You've probably tired of hearing that broken record at this point. So Anderson now back to serve. Scramble mode for IUPUI. Off the block, and again, great hustle by the Eagles, but USI could not track it down. Teams alternating points here to start set number three. So here's Long. And that one, Anderson couldn't get out of the way, ace. Anderson thought that ball was going to steer wide and just couldn't get that boot out of the way. Block there waiting in Ostrowski. Jaguars asked for a double contact. Frankly, it's not going to matter. Block steers it wide. Point goes to IUPUI regardless. So the 3 points so far for USI, two have been gifted by the Jaguars so far. Touch there, we play on. Parika got a hand to it, but couldn't do anything with it. So tied at 4 points apiece. Come on, come on. Short ball, big swing. Free ball here. And Parika takes the chance for the kill. There's plenty of coaches kidding her, so she saw that developing. And took the swing to end the point. She doesn't get many of those, but does take advantage when given the opportunity. Good dig by Phillips. Harris. And Phillips is there. Going over on two. Phillips has it covered. Big swing and the result for IUPUI. I think that was the longest rally of the match. And it belongs to the Jaguars. Tough serve. Three in a row now for IUPUI. Short ball block there waiting. That belonged to Emily Allen. So four chain here for IUPUI. Good job to change the swing by Bianca Anderson. After you had one come right back at you, change the tempo. So point to the Screaming Eagles. Bednarda, sir. An outstanding serve at that. Good angle. Parika couldn't sneak it by on two. Harris. Touch there. Again, there could be a challenge coming here, but Coach O'Coin electing not to as of now. So we play on. Parika. Off the slide. Nothing to do with that. Anderson, well done. Haven't seen the slide work much for either team today. It did there for USI. So IUPUI will give it a try, and great effort. Stayed in play. Free ball. How about that? Let's see if that changed the momentum of the match. Look at that thing. Was going to be down on the floor. It's a pancake of the silver dollar variety that time by USI. Anderson finishes it off. But then USI with a freebie for the Jaguars on the service miscue. Their sixth of the match. Anderson, right play. Good coverage by Harris. And that's going to be a point on a fourth touch. That was not off the block. That was off the net. It's a miscue on the swing. Jaguars maintaining pretty solid hitting numbers in the third set. Difference is that USI is a little closer to joining them. Jags hitting 278 here in the set. A buck 76 for USI. Block is there. Downing got that one. Then back to a 1-point lead for IUPUI. the libero, and Moore to serve. Yeah, tough serve at that. Short ball and bombs away. Emily Allen, just her second kill of the match. Give Parika a 25th assist on the evening. And there's no split set in the offense. It's Parika's offense to run. Downing, and when it's off the line, Judge, that's a point for the home team when it didn't hit somebody before it got to said line, Judge. That, I think there was a touch there. Nope. Was not. The USI wins that one. White with the errant swing that time. She's got six kills on the night. Harris, 12, leads both sides. Ostrowski, no doubt about that. Well, she has clearly shown an ability. You know, some players, you have to kind of pass to a certain spot. You can have a pretty big window to find her. Anderson. Net contact against IUPUI. Here's Leah Anderson. Off the block and down, point to USI. Maya Long couldn't do much with that. And again, Ostrowski wasn't the best pass, and Parika, she was, Ostrowski was a little kind of off her swing, but she'll find a way to get the job done. That's error number 13 on a serve by IUPUI, third in this set. Here's Crowder. Ostrowski again. Put it in the building. She'll find a way to get it to the back line. So the point to IUPUI, that leads us to a media timeout. So midway through set number three, Jaguars with a slim advantage. We'll see who can win this crucial third set when we return to the jungle on the campus of IUPUI. First this, the major moves pillar of the Horizon League experience highlights our commitment to innovation and a forward-thinking approach to challenges while addressing emerging trends in all aspects of the college sports environment. To learn more about the major moves across the Horizon League, visit horizonleague.com/brand-recharge-an-ace. For IUPUI, we have lamented the aces versus errors ratio. Point for IUPUI. And that's going to be, I believe, double contact. Yep. Violation against USI. So the Jaguars' lead grows to 7. Or grows to 4, excuse me, at 17-13. Big swing. 50-50 ball. Good job to chicken wing it by Parika. Harris. Jaguars able to somehow scramble and get that done. Tape and then 3 touches. Sometimes the bounces simply go your way. 1, 2, 3. What a read. I think the reaction on Coach McCoy's face says it all. Not exactly much you need to game plan on that one. It was tape, touch, net, touch, and then the third shot that ends up steering it along the back line. Coach McCoy, who spent time in the men's volleyball program at Ball State, spent 10 years at Harvard University before joining the program at USI. Remember the club volleyball team on the men's side, the University of New Hampshire. Coach Kroger talking with his young team, trying to make it back-to-back sets. And it's always important when you can beat an in-state rival. Those results certainly mention when it comes to the recruiting aspect of things. I guarantee you these two teams are potentially going for the same types of players to help build these programs. Can IUPUI trying to return to being a top-flight program at their level of sport? Out and no touch. Point to IUPUI. And while it's been a struggle these last handful of years for IUPUI, when you see the action kind of going back and forth here, you'll see a good amount of banners on both sides. The banners on the side of the court that IUPUI is serving from now, those largely belong to the women's basketball team, and especially under the tutelage of Austin Parkinson. What this program did both in the Summit League and since in the Horizon League, and the number of postseason tournaments they have been to. Those banners on your right, those are all volleyball banners. It's been a few years, but it can be done at IUPUI in terms of volleyball success. Block is there. Good scramble by the Screaming Eagles. Going over on two, and Parika couldn't get that done. Maybe a little anxious on that one. So point to USI.
Abby Bednar serving
for the Screaming
Eagles.
And wide. Now we've talked about the amount of points given up by IUPUI in those service errors, and USI has not done that as much, but seemingly have done that at key times to just kind of block any momentum. Free ball and kill for IUPUI. And Emily Allen now with two in the set, three for the match. 37 kills in total for IUPUI, 25 for the visitors from Evansville. Scrambling effort there, ball kept in play. Free ball, but we still play on. Parika, Harris, and for Harris, that's a Baker's dozen, 13 of those for her tonight. Jaguars won the second set by eight. They lead this set by eight, and Harris matches what is a career high for her in kills from last week against Drake. The response there by Weber. And Weber, the HSE grad, will serve this one up. And Harris has a new high in kills. And now she'll head back to serve. And Harris played at Noblesville. Jaguars 2 points away from a 2-1 lead. Block there waiting. Was there a touch there? Yes. Point to USI. Some more to serve. Allen. And make it 8 set points, much as was the case a set ago for IUPUI. Off the block and down, Downing with her fourth kill of the match. Jaguars in this set hitting 263. USI right around the 100 mark for this set. And that's it. So second versed, same as the third, I suppose. Jaguars win back-to-back sets 25-17 after USI claims set number one. 25-22. Jaguars look to make it 3 in a row and claim their 5th non-conference victory of the season. USI is trying to push this to 5. Back in a moment as you're watching Horizon League Volleyball on ESPN+. Harris hitting a crisp 303 so far for the match. IUPUI as a team hitting 225. Jaguars to serve, and seems fitting that a service error starts things off for IUPUI. So Anderson now back to serve for USI. Short ball, big swing, block there, point there for USI. And a service error given right back by the Screaming Eagles. That's 8 of those for USI. Harris now will rotate in, replacing Brianna Brown. Brown has been a 1 rotation player as well for IUPUI. Jaguars again in a charitable mood as they hand it right back to Southern Indiana. Big swing. Good hustle by USI. Just couldn't control the caroms. Could Moore or Downing. Allen rotates back in now for IUPUI. Ostrowski the dig. Short ball to Allen, and Allen. Rika again tried to go over on 2. Jaguars keep it in play. Harris blocked there waiting. One of the better rallies of the match continues. And just an errant swing by Downing. Just couldn't time the leap right. Was almost back to the floor by the time she touched it. Point to IUPUI. Parika again with the lefty hook that time. And I mentioned this in the second set, that there's not many chances for her to get a kill. It's not necessarily true for her as a setter. And she plays a little taller than her height that's listed at 5'7". No touch there. Another freebie given away by IUPUI. But Parika actually had 44 kills coming into the match. In other words, she's averaging more than 1 per set. Big swing block there waiting. So back-to-back points for USI. Screaming Eagles serve at 5-4. That's an ace. That one following instructions well. Crowder back to serve. Off the slide, and that's a point for IUPUI. Allen starting to bump those hitting numbers a bit higher up as well. For the senior from Burlington, Wisconsin. It was an area that IUPUI recruited heavily from over the years, and Jaguars continue to be generous from their own serve. Now Allen remains as the only Wisconsin native currently on the squad. Allen. Point for IUPUI, and again, not much on the swing. I think Coach Coyne asked, was there maybe a little bit of early contact by IUPUI? I don't think so. Harris to serve. Downing into the block. Anderson. Perica. And off the block, Jaguars just couldn't rotate back in time. USI just not letting IUPUI build any early momentum here in this set. Took a little while for the Jaguars to kind of get that momentum going in set number three. It was early in set number two. Block. Jaguars peel it back. White missed it. But there's a touch there, yes. Point to IUPUI. Good job by Anderson. Good read. Kind of threw it off the blocker that time. Well done. Reference the fact there are four seniors that are on this USI squad. We have seen three of them in Crowder, Anderson, and Bednar. See major minutes tonight, Ostrowski. He's done a good job of kind of swinging around the passes from Perica so far. Couldn't do much with that one. So back to a two-point Screaming Eagle lead until right now. Make it one. Point for USR, point for IUPUI, excuse me. This has been the ebb and flow of this set. Sure, we got a rotation question here. Aha. Little perspiration got to the floor, hence the reason for the delay. And Phillips' serve is long again. That is now 18 free points that USI has picked up on service errors by IUPUI. And to put it in perspective, they've scored 17. In each of the last two sets. But USI gives it right back. Oh. Good recovery by USI. Set across. Out. And no touch. So we're tied at 11. Short set, good swing, good coverage by Phillips. Harris. Perica, and again Ostrowski. Yep, bad pass by Perica. And Grace is having a tough time, seemingly on the passes to Ostrowski, trying to figure out, okay, what's the path of the pass to get to clearly one of IUPUI's better players. Timing seems to be set. Passes to other hitters, but not to Ostrowski for whatever reason. Block is there. Walls that one off for USI. Eagles with a two-point advantage. But that one is out. Phillips was a good 5 feet behind the service line watching that one fly by. I'm not sure that either of these teams are putting on a serving clinic anytime soon. Ostrowski. Block there. And again, this has been kind of the way this fourth has gone. USI will bump up to a 1 or 2 point lead. IUPUI will quickly reel them back. Got the line. Point to the Screaming Eagles. For Weber, that is her fourth kill of the night. 30th as a team for USI. Jaguars with 46. Tough serve. Perica did what she could. And that ricochets off the block. Point to USI. That will lead us to a media timeout. Screaming Eagles have to win this one to force a fifth and decisive set. USI leads it 15-13 in set number four. As you're watching Horizon League Volleyball, we'll have the replay take you to break. Indiana, IUPUI, it's been real simple in terms of how the sets have gone for them. The two sets they have won, they hit 323 and 282. The set they lost was 098. This set, triple zeros for IUPUI. That'll help. Allen read the scenario very well. And the Jags back within a point. Knuckler of a serve. Libero steers it over. Perica. Touch. There's a touch. Point to IUPUI. So this has been the story again. USI will score a couple. Jags will score a couple. Which team can get a longer run? That'll help for IUPUI. They've now scored three in a row coming out of the break, and they have the serve and the lead, looking to win it in four. Again, another wicked serve by Perica. 50-50 ball at IUPUI. Harris helps ensure that that ball heads in the proper direction from the home perspective. Make it four in a row now for IUPUI. Perica gets the help of the tape and the ace. Timeout coming for USI. Coach O'Coin will use the timeout, and absolutely, Grace, you should be excited about the effort that time. And as we stated earlier, USI will not be in action until league play starts on Monday. They'll take on Eastern Illinois, and EIU heading into the week, 9-0 on the season are the Panthers. Something that's very unique in the OVC, and maybe this was a COVID invention that carried over. There's a few of those from 3-4 years ago at this point. But basically, instead of not just a full round robin, which is what you do in the Horizon League, play it twice, but you're going to play back-to-back days in the same location. In other words, if you're on the road at Tennessee Tech, you're there for Friday and Saturday. If Little Rock's at your place, you're there on Friday and Saturday. But that's the way the OVC does it. The Horizon League is still, you're going to play a full round robin both home and road throughout the course of the season. So a rare Monday night conference opener for USI next week. And for IUPUI, they will play in Terre Haute against Indiana State. That is on Friday night. And they open up league play against Cleveland State on Tuesday. We'll have that one for you on ESPN+. John Herrick will have the call. Harris. But errant swing by USI. And Jaguars are nudging themselves towards the finish line. Off the slide, block is there. Big swing for the back by Anderson. Can you read the rafter ball? No. And you don't see it on the screen, but you saw the players quickly try to change course. It is not the highest of ceilings. You're inside of this building that's just a little more than 40 years old now on the IUPUI campus. Parika. Two players try to take up the same real estate. Big swing. And again, a rafter ball and back-to-back points for Southern Indiana. And they slice the IUPUI lead in half. After six consecutive IUPUI points, back-to-back tallies by the visitors. Pivotal point here. Set across, and Harris again. Roof and down. All of a sudden, the sky has become a magnet in the IUPUI gymnasium. And the Jaguars five away from snapping what is also a four-match losing streak. But service error number 19 creeps in for IUPUI. There you see the creative use of the rafters in the IUPUI jungle, notating the various Horizon League schools, and that one ricochets to the back of the court. IUPUI rotated forward, and USI now within a point. So the Screaming Eagles not going down without a fight. And after one win in their debut Division I season last year, they enter at 4-6. Allen. Well, Allen has continued to improve as the match has gone along. That is her seventh kill. And she's the only IUPUI player hitting north of 300 in this match, 375 to be precise. Off the slide, steps weren't right. Free ball IUPUI. And then a wild lefty swing. That time from White. White does have 10 kills, but that puts her now hitting sub 150 on the evening. Soborowski. Good dig. Free ball. USI levels us at 21. Ostrowski works around it. She has been like a catcher that has framed fastball 6 inches out of the zone. A little perspiration needs to be taken care of on the Jaguar logo. Soborowski wants to make sure she's got the proper traction in which to operate her office there in front of the net. Phillips to serve. Anderson. Off the block and down. Jaguars 2 points away from closing it out. And USI does have one timeout they can use. You'd think they would save that for when IUPUI gets to 24. Phillips, tough one. Block is there. Diving effort by IUPUI, but could not get to it in time. Point to USI. Coach Kroger appreciates the hustle. Now it's Anderson. Jaguars will take a little time to mop the floor, too. And IUPUI couldn't pull the serve. So now it's who's going to get a two-point lead first. Big swing and a match point for IUPUI. Well, after Long couldn't read the serve, Long fires one straight down. And it is Long who goes right back to serve. Off the block. Parika. Ostrowski, good night. Well, set number four was not as pretty as sets two and three for IUPUI, but the end result is a thing of beauty. Jaguars snap a four-match losing streak, level their record at 5-5 on the season, and again, for the first time officially playing USI since October of 1996. The Jaguars welcome their new Division I rivals in the state with a loss in four sets at the IUPUI Gymnasium. Well, the Jaguars now 5-5 on the season. USI falls to 4-7. Best of luck to Coach O'Corn and the Screaming Eagles in their second season in the OVC. One more non-conference matchup comes up for IUPUI. They play at Indiana State on Friday. Be sure to join us on Tuesday when they host Cleveland State to open up Horizon League play.